Alright. Check, test, test, test! Hello?
After the last video of me talking extensively about firearms and politics, I'm gonna do the most dangerous change of topics to ever come out of a bird and start talking about military aviation. Because that's not gonna put me on the list at all. In the late 50s, the Soviet Union wanted to have another supersonic interceptor for its air force. Solve the hunger crisis, build better military assets, give Ukrainian rights, build better military assets. So to remedy that, they called Miko and Gurevich about another contract for a fighter. I guess they didn't have enough of those yet. The Air Force requirements were maximum speed of at least Mach 2, no more than 10 tons, and a max ceiling of 60,000 feet.
Oh, that's hot! That's hot!
So Miklan said yes, God forbid they didn't. Then they proceeded to build an airframe and working prototype in less than a year, to present them to the Communist Party officers. No, there's no such thing as political pressure here, comrade. Even though the aircraft MiG had come up with did comply with the requirements of the Air Force, it surely had its fair share of problems.
Vou colocar isso aqui no YouTube, véi.
The wings were too short to provide any lift at slow speeds, meaning the aircraft would simply become an 8-ton rock at speeds lower than 250 km/h. Because of that, landing this thing was about as safe as a Russian roulette. The recommended landing speed for that thing was about as fast as a 2000's F1 car. And it didn't help the fact that during most of the approach, the pilot couldn't see the ground at all, because the nose of the aircraft would block his view. That thing already sounds like a death trap, and I'm yet to talk about warfare. With that many issues, it's really strange that the Soviet Air Force just signed it up as ready to produce. I wonder if there were any reasons for the rush at all. Oh yeah, I forgot, of course.